Here we are in the Tyrannus. I'm going to center both of the sticks, and I'm going to push to the right with the throttle. Ta-da!
I'm Joshua Bardwell, and you're going to learn something today. Your FPV camera has a whole bunch of settings that affect how the image looks, and if you're like most people, you don't mess with those settings. Because in order to mess with those settings, you need one of these little joysticks that you plug into the back of the camera, and you access the OSD menu. And even if you do have one of those with you, like if you're a nerd like me who carries one with you to the field in your backpack, you gotta fish it in there and plug it into the back of the camera, and you can't do that. Well, today I'm gonna show you why you can get rid of these forever, because Betaflight has the ability to access the camera's OSD from your transmitter sticks. Does that sound cool? Yeah, stay tuned. The feature that we're talking about today is a real game changer. It's called Betaflight Camera Controller, OSD Camera Controller. It's a game changer because those settings in your camera, and specifically like brightness and contrast, maybe automatic gain control, they significantly affect how the camera is responding to the ambient lighting conditions. And if you look out on the internet, you can find lots of videos saying, best settings for 1177 Rotor Riot Swift. Everybody's got their idea of the best settings. And it's a real shame that we have to search for the best settings for every lighting condition. Wouldn't it be nice to be able to change those settings in response to the different lighting conditions? The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to physically wire the camera up. And then the second thing I'm going to do is I'm going to show you what you have to do in Betaflight, in the configurator, to make the feature work. And in order to wire it up, you have to choose a pin on the flight controller that you're going to solder to. And the pin that you're going to choose is, it's not a UART. You might think, oh, it's just like a serial connection with a UART. It's not. You're going to choose a pin. Well, the key thing is that the pin has a dedicated timer. You know, unless you're a developer, you probably, that means nothing to you. A timer is an internal resource in the actual microprocessor on the flight controller, and the developers assign timers to different pins, and sometimes different pins will share a timer. They can do that. Well, the pin that we use for camera control has to have its own timer. And one way to figure out pins that will work is to go look in the source code yeah, and see what timers are assigned to what pins. Don't do that. The other thing you can do is you can always use the LED strip pin on your flight controller. Assuming that you're not using programmable LEDs, you can use the LED strip pin, and I'll show you how to do that. The LED strip pin always has a dedicated timer. If you have a quadcopter with more than four motor outputs, as like the F405 board I'm working with has six motor outputs, and that's great because although very few of us use hexacopters, many of us have a use for those extra two motor outputs for things like this. The extra motor outputs probably also have their own timers and probably can be used. So we're going to be using the LED strip pin because I'm not using LEDs on this quadcopter. If you are using LEDs, then you better hope you have a board with extra motor outputs. And if you don't have either of those, you got to go look at the source code and you might just not even be able to do it. Sorry. Once you've selected a pin, the next thing you're going to need to do is you're going to need to get a resistor. And the resistor needs to be between 150 and 600 ohms. Now, I have here a handy dandy little resistor kit. Buying just like one resistor is pretty expensive, and well, if you have the internet, you could probably buy one resistor. That's all you need. But if you do electronics, getting a little kit like this is very handy and much, much cheaper. You know, you get way more resistors for your buck. But I'll put a link to this down in the video description. You can find other resistors, individual resistors, on sites like DigiKey or Mauser or all over the internet. Now, if you have a flight controller that already has a camera control pin on it, and there are a few of them out there, one that comes to mind is the CL Racing F4S. That's the second generation flight controller from CL Racing. And I've heard from other manufacturers that are adding them to their flight controllers. It will already have this resistor installed on it. You do not need to do what I'm about to do. And also, if you have one of those flight controllers with the camera control pin already on it, you also don't need to select a pin or think about a timer or give up your LED strip. all you will do is just solder the wire to that camera control pin on the flight controller. But most of us these days don't have a flight controller with a built-in camera control pin. 6 months from now, this video, this part of the video may not really even matter. So I've got my 220 ohm resistor, and then I'm going to connect it in between the camera on the signal pin of the OSD wire. Now I'm working with this little extension here. That's just a convenient way to get to plug into the OSD on my camera. The exact way that you do this will depend on how your camera is wired. And I'm going to plug this in. And before I start soldering, I'm just going to take a measurement with my multimeter. I've got the multimeter set to DC volts. I'm going to plug the quadcopter in, and I'm going to measure between the two wires. I'm going to measure between the two wires coming out of the OSD connector, ground and the signal wire, and I'm going to measure the voltage there. And it should be 3.3 volts, but that's what I want to check. Okay. So here I'm getting 2.88 volts. That's surprising, but that is what it is. That's why I measured it, I guess. 2.89 volts. All right. We're going to make a note of that in case it matters later. It's easy to do that now while you're getting ready to solder everything up. Just make a note of that number, but measured between the signal and the ground on your FPV camera. Signal, not your video signal, the OSD, the red wire coming out of the OSD, or in this case, it's a blue wire. So I've soldered the resistor here onto the signal wire, and then I'm gonna just add a little bit of extra wire here to extend the ground and the signal out so they can reach where they need to go. I'm gonna be using this. This is silicon insulated hookup wire. This is a really great thing to have around. Silicon wire, of course, much better than plastic insulation. Doesn't melt when you solder it. It's very nice, flexible, easy to strip with your fingernails. This hookup wire is on my, I just added a new page to my Ultimate FPV shopping list for supplies for things like heat shrink and glue and solder and wire, and there's a link to this on there. I'll put a link in the video description as well. This is great stuff. It's available all the way down to like, from like 22 down to like 32 gauge. You can get any size you want. Comes in different colors. Very nice to have around. So here is my little plug all made up. I've got the resistor on the signal wire, and I've just got an extension on the ground wire. If you have a full-size camera, then that is probably all you need to do. But if you have some of the mini and most, if not all, of the micro cameras, you'll also need to add a capacitor. The larger cameras have enough capacitance already on the signal pin to make this work. The other ones don't. And the capacitor needs to be at least 0.1 microfarad, and you're going to need to install that, and this is critical, you're going to need to install that on the camera side of the adapter. So here's where the camera is going to plug in, and you would solder that on the resistor like so. I'm just bending these legs to make it clear. Between signal and ground, like so. And it needs to go on the camera side of the resistor. So that wouldn't work because you can see the camera is going to be here, and it's on the flight controller side of the resistor. That is not where you need it. You need it here. And of course, I'm bending the legs just to make it obvious where it goes, but you could make it all neat, of course. And then I'm going to go ahead and install this and solder it up, and I'll just make sure that I've got enough length to be able to remove this without tugging on it. I might even want to run it under the flight controller so it's not rattling on the, this is the gyro chip right here. I don't like the idea that it would be like rattling on top of it. There's a little bit of weight here to the resistor. You could of course have soldered the resistor direct to the LED pin if you so desire, but that's not how I decided to do it because I don't know why. Now we've got the camera OSD connector wired to LED strip here and a ground connection, and the next thing to do is to go over to the computer and set it up in Betaflight. I'm going to connect to the board in Betaflight
and I'm going to go to the command line. And I'm going to type the command resource. And in the output of that command, I'm going to look for the pin that I soldered the camera control wire to. So in my case, it was the LED strip pin. But if you used a motor like motor 5 or motor 6, or gosh, some other pin, then you're going to look for that one. And I'm going to look for the pin number. So the output of this command is that these are resource names. LED strip is a resource that the board knows about. The motor outputs are resources that the board knows about that it can use. And then these are actual pin designations. The syntax is a little weird, like what is a B06? But it suffice it to say that B06 is the way that Betaflight knows what physical pin that this resource is mapped to. So I'm going to remember this number. B06. If I had used motor number 6 as my camera control pin, then I would remember A08. If I had used motor 5, I would remember A15, and so on. B06 is going to be my magic number. By the way, I need to tell you, if you're using a board like the CL Racing F4, or as I said earlier, there are more boards coming out with the camera control pin built in. If you're using one of those boards, then you do not need to do any of this. Your board came from the factory, ready to go. All you have to do is solder the camera control wire to the camera control pin, and 99% of the time, you're going to be good to go. So you can skip this whole resource reassignment section of the video if you have one of those boards, you lucky bastard. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to assign the resource to that pin by typing resource camera underscore control, and then the pin number, which in my case is B06. And I want you to pay close attention to the output of this command. God damn it. I really think that's correct. What did I type wrong? Oh. I'm a fucking idiot, that's what. Yeah, did I mention that you need to be on Betaflight 3.2? Yeah. Okay. You got to be on Betaflight 3.2 or this won't work. Let's try that again. Resource. Oh, there we go. I knew that didn't look right. B06 is my pin. Now then, resource camera control B06. Pay very close attention to the output of the command. Notice that the command is telling me that B06 is already assigned to resource LED strip and I2C SCL. And this is where I remind you of a little bit of background about the resource command. The resource command shows the pin assignments that you would like the board to have. But in this case, there's multiple things that have been assigned to this pin. Well, only one of them can really have the pin at a time. That's not always true, but it's often true. And we need camera control to be the only thing on this pin. So how do you know what is actually using the pin? You know, It's like you go to a restaurant and you place an order, right? That's what you like to get. And then the food comes back from the kitchen, and that's what you really got. Well, the resource command is like we've put our order in. That's what we're asking for. The way to find what the board is actually doing is the command resource list. So this is like what you actually got, and sometimes that will match what you asked for, but if what you asked for is contradictory, you're only going to get one of those things. So take a look here. If we look at pin B06, we notice that B06 is currently assigned to the resource I2C SCL. Even though if we type resource, we can see that we would like to put on pin B06. Well, we'd like it to be LED strip. Yeah. We'd like it to be I2C SCL, whatever that is. And sure, we'd like it to be camera control. It's going to be one of those three things, whichever, I don't know how it decides. So what we need to do is we need to clear up these resources by typing resource LED strip 1, none, and resource I2C SCL 1, none. Basically taking everything that is asking to be on pin B06 and saying, no, don't ask for that. And now when I type save and reboot the board, and reconnect, and I type resource list, notice that on pin B06, I've got camera control. If you do not see this when you type resource list, camera control will not work for you. And again, as a reminder, if you are a lucky bugger who has a board with camera control already just built in, you don't have to do any of this. Going back to the wiki, we can see the other thing that we need to do is we need to set camera control key delay equals 125. I'll just copy and paste that in and save. Now what that does is it controls basically how long the flight controller is going to hold the button down for. And sometimes you need that to be a little longer and a little shorter depending on the exact electrical conditions of the resistor and the capacitor and all that stuff. So basically, if you find that when you move your joystick on your transmitter, you get a double press, click, click, it goes down twice in the menu. Or sometimes it'll go and scroll really fast, then reduce the camera control key delay. If you find that when you tick the joystick, nothing happens, you can try increasing the camera control key delay. Maybe if you just hold that button down a little longer, it'll work. But you might need to do things like if you didn't add a capacitor, you might need to add a capacitor. And there are various other things in the wiki, in the troubleshooting section, for things you can do like measure the reference voltage. I had you do that earlier. If your reference voltage was not 3.3 volts, you might need to change the reference voltage. Or you might even need to do this sort of semi-complicated process for checking the internal resistance. But most of us should be able to get this working simply by doing the things I've shown you so far. If the things I've shown you don't work, the next thing to do is to add a capacitor. And then if that doesn't work, then you go in and you start screwing around with those extra things in the troubleshooting section. Here we are in the Tyrannus. I'm going to center both of the sticks, and I'm going to push to the right with the throttle. Ta-da! Boom! And then I can use this stick to go up and down in the menu, right? And if I want to enter or click the button, it's like that. And you can do whatever you need to do. And that's so exciting. Leave any questions you've got down in the comments. Thanks for watching. Happy flying.